Just imagine this. Imagine if you were the absolute authority in your industry for like cooking recipes. And then anytime somebody wanted a cooking recipe, the first thought that came to mind is, I'm going to go to Chef John's page. I'm going to go see what he's cooking. John, I don't know what spices, I don't know what seasonings, I don't know what items and ingredients I need to make this recipe. What should I do? People would do that because I'm the authority in the space. And that's one of the reasons why you should have a podcast, is you should be the absolute authority in whatever space that you're in so you can create a monopoly in the market. But come on in, come on in, come on in, because I'm going to share with you six more reasons why you should start a podcast right now for your business. Let's get into the episode. Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. What's going on, family? What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. I'm your host, Jonathan Jones. And as you know, this is your number one source for podcast news. Also for podcast news, and coming very shortly in the next few weeks, we're going to roll out podcast interviews. All right. So I'm looking forward to that and looking forward to continue to not only enlighten you just with how to's and news, but bringing on and introducing you to some of my friends in the podcasting space and hearing some of their stories and how they've been able to achieve the level of success that they've been able to achieve thus far. All right. So before we dive into the episode, I want to let you know that this episode is sponsored by getpaidwithpodcasting.com. All right. And there we're hosting a training for speakers, coaches, consultants, showing you how to take your voice and turn it into a profitable business. All right. So you can go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. We're going to have that down in the show notes so you can go ahead and get registered. Now, let's talk a little bit about podcast news, all right? Amazon is doing what Amazon does, and they're buying exclusive rights to My Favorite Murder. This is another murder mystery podcast, and Amazon just likes getting ahead of the curve and ultimately just likes being able to be in the position to where they can create a monopoly in every industry, it seems like, all right? So it's said that ultimately with Amazon taking this on, this is just another podcast into the fold. All right. So enough about them. Then also out in podcast news, Timber, no pun intended, is close. 3 weeks or so, according to Tanner Campbell, the host of Podcasting Sucks, they're going to go ahead and shut their doors. Sad to see. Timber was a podcast host company. This was a startup podcast host company, fairly new, and they're getting ready just to shut their doors. So, Timber, we appreciate you and what you've done for the community, and we'll see you on the other side. All right? We'll see you on the other side. And also, shout out to Castos, which is a podcast hosting company. They have added customizable podcast website themes to their offerings, to their service. So shout out to Castos for bringing that into play. And then last but certainly not least, this took place on Monday, right? This took place a little bit earlier this week. A former McDonald's drive-through cashier has signed a multi-year, multi-million dollar podcast deal with his former employer, Gary Koyich, I believe it is. He's the CEO of Pod Digital Media, which has partnered with McDonald's to help them reach multicultural audiences. Mr. Gary, the CEO, shout out to you, my good sir. Shout out to you. So that wraps up this week's podcast news, which has been brought to you by GetPaidWithPodcasting.com. which is the webinar that we're going to be showing you exactly how you can take your voice and turn it into a profitable business, even if you have a small audience. All right, let's get into this content. I want you just to think about this. Like I was talking about before, right? I was talking about before, if somebody's trying to cook in the position to where they want to put together a recipe, you're the first person that comes to mind. If you're a business owner, if you're a speaker, if you're a coach, if you're a consultant, whatever industry you're in, you want to be that person, period. So I want to encourage you to find innovative and strategic ways to position yourself that way. How do you do that? The first step would be starting a podcast for your business. And we're about to lay down 7 reasons why. Let's get into it. The first reason: having a podcast will help you drive your search rankings up via SEO. John, what's SEO? Search engine optimization. So think about every time somebody types in how to start a podcast, and then hopefully your podcast mentor will pop up, or somebody says, how do I create better audio on my podcast, right? So if we have episode titles that fall in line with those questions, those sentences, then the more people search for them and the more hits we get on our website, then our website is going to start to rise to the top of those searches. So then after so many people search for it, then with us being the first, the second, the third, or the fourth search, now they'll just assume that based on me ranking so high, I'm the go-to in the industry. I'm the authority. We have an association, right? The association basically is, if I see you at the top or I see you as a higher ranker, maybe even if you cost more, then I'm going to assume that you're the best. Point blank, period, right? So understanding that it helps increase that SEO and the ranking for our websites. And then the second reason: a podcast makes you an authority on a topic that you frequent, right? So ESPN considers themselves to be the worldwide leader in sports. Why is that? Because they cover Monday Night Football, because they have Sports Center that runs all throughout the day. They'll give you cricket. They'll give you badminton. They'll give you bowling. They'll give you extreme sports. It makes it easy for us just to associate ESPN being the number one leader in sports because they play sports all through the day, all through the night. Fox plays games during the day on Sunday. CBS during the game on Sunday, maybe on Saturdays during playoff times, but you're not going to get it 24/7. But that's what ESPN does, and that's why they're the authority in that space. So I want you to think about, what is something that you can continually talk about day in and day out, in the middle of the night, early in the morning, in the middle of the day at lunch? You should be able to find a way to how you can structure your content around your business, around your book, around your service, around your offering. And that's what we do in the Get Paid With Podcasting program with my clients. I always work with them to help them establish their buckets, right? So what are the three buckets? What are the three pillars that you're going to break down and focus your content towards? It just makes it that much easier when we get to that point, into that place. So we want to keep that in mind. We want to keep that in mind. And I'm not sure if you ever seen that Verizon commercial, right? Growing up, I would see the guy on the Verizon commercial. I think his name was like Jason or something. You would see him pick up his phone. He would say, he would say, can you hear me now? Then the guy wouldn't say nothing. He'd take a few steps. He'd say, can you hear me now? He wouldn't say anything. He'd say, can you hear me now? And then Jason would smile, look at the camera and say, okay, good, good, good. And then one thing that you would notice at the end of the commercial was, Jason would start to get this group of people following him. It started with one person. Then you would see 3 people. Then you would see 5. Then 50. What does that have to do with starting a podcast, and why is that relevant for now and even within your business? First things first, okay? First things first. Jason was developing a tribe. Wherever you are, whatever your business, whatever your industry is, you have certain people who are locked in to everything that you do. They have the notification button on. They subscribe to your email list. They want to know when you drop a new product. They want to know if you have something new to offer. They want to know, okay? Because they are a loyal follower. So now let's think about it like this. Imagine if somebody was following your business that loyal. And imagine if you only had a newsletter for them every Monday of the week. What are they going to do the other rest of the days of the week? Now we can create a podcast for them to hear. So now on Monday, you can drop the newsletter still if you decide to. But then you can get creative and innovative with the content you roll out through the week. Let's say that you're a restaurant that provides meals, or you're a company or organization that provides meals. Let's say on Monday, you do a Monday mega meal with protein. And then on Tuesday, you do a terrific Taste Buds Tuesday, right? And then you talk about some of the ingredients that go in the meal. Then on Wednesday, you say it's a Wednesday, or you say it's a wings day. And then you break down different types of wings that you have to offer, or vegan wings, or whatever it might be. And by doing this, now you're taking that loyal follower, and then ultimately, you're allowing them to come one level deeper with you, right? So with you having a podcast, this is the third reason, with you having a podcast, podcasts create loyal tribes and loyal listeners. Like seriously, some people will be upset if you say you're going to release an episode on Wednesday and you don't release an episode. But John, I don't want people to be mad at me if I don't release an episode. No. You're missing the point. They're so connected to your content, you become a part of their daily or weekly routine. Imagine that. Imagine the power that you have being a part of somebody's weekly routine. Hello. Prolific. Okay? Prolific. So don't not release that episode, but make sure you just get a good schedule, right? A good schedule, a good system. To roll that thing out. A lot of businesses struggle trying to figure out, what content do I put out? What do I say today? What do I do tomorrow? John, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do. Having a podcast, now after you record that audio or that audio and video, now you can just repurpose it. You can cut up clips. You can cut out the highlights and then share that with your audience. John, why do I cut out the highlights? Because if you cut little snippets, it's almost like a preview or like an appetizer. So after people hear this, you leave them hanging with a little bit and they say, well, where can I get the rest of it? How can I get the rest of it? And then you begin to draw them in. Because once you get somebody to listen to one episode and they enjoy what you're putting out, you've hit on your target listener, or you've hit on your target audience, because you already have identified who that is. And I'll link that video in the show notes because we did that a previous weeks ago. Once you know who the target audience is, you know what their struggle is, you're providing content for that individual, and then they're going to begin to binge. They're going to begin to watch. They're going to begin to digest everything that you put out, because they understand and they know that you're meeting their need. Period. And it all came from you having the ability to repurpose content from your podcast. As opposed to every week you struggling and you biting and you fighting and trying to figure out, what am I going to put out now? Because I don't know. I can't put out another picture this week. I don't know what to do. Start a podcast so you can cut up clips. You can take snippets. You can even do a screen record of episodes and then drop 30 second, 1 minute clips, 2 minute clips, just to give people enough to draw them in. Right? Because if you draw them in, once again, going back to the first point, you're increasing your SEO search. So let's not forget about that. Okay? Let's keep on going. Let's keep on going. Number five, you. Okay, I want you to think about this. Where do I want to go? Do I want to tell this story? Okay, let's go back to college. And it's funny that when I was in college, there was a group of people that I would hang with, probably about half boys, half girls, right? And over time, the more we started hanging around these young ladies, then some people began to get in relationships with each other. Why did they start to get in relationships with each other, John? Because the closeness of the proximity. The more time you spend with somebody, the more you get to determine if you like them or if you don't. And then as you begin to determine that, then you'll say, I want to hang around a little bit longer. Hey, where are we going tonight? Where are we going tomorrow? Because that's creating an intimate connection with somebody. A podcast is, by way, the best way to create an intimate connection with somebody whom you may never speak to directly, but depending on how you create your content and how you roll out your episodes and how you talk to your audience, this now positions you to create that intimate connection. And you have the ability to build an intimate connection with your listener. People listen to podcasts in the tub. People listen to podcasts in the car. People listen to podcasts on the plane. Wherever they go, they're going to take their phone. And according to my Googles, I just did a search, 7.26 billion people, I believe this is projected because it was 7.12 billion people that actually had phones in the world in 2021. But the 7.26 billion would make up 91.69% of the world's population with a phone. Family, what am I saying? I'm saying that 91.69, might as well call it 92%. I'm not big on saying everybody, but just about everybody has a phone. That's 9 out of 10 people have phones. And if we take these everywhere and we're checking them every 30 seconds, every minute, you want to be in the palm of somebody's hand. So therefore, you want to have that podcast. You know what I'm saying? You want to have that podcast. So look. Understanding that as business owners, a lot of us struggle at whatever level, right? At whatever level, a lot of us struggle to decrease the bottom line. I mean, depending on how you look at it, right? Increase or decrease, depending on how you look at it. Hey, look at it. The bottom line matters. And in order to generate more revenue, right? In order to generate more revenue, you have to get in front of more people. But the best way to generate more revenue is to create a connection with people who will continue to buy from you, continue to spend with you, continue to want to know more about your offers, your programs, your services, and then you retain that customer. Why is that relevant here? It's relevant because the sixth point I want to share with you is this. Loyal listeners can turn into loyal customers. I saw some research a few weeks ago. I believe it was according to Spotify. And they were just talking about, or it was on eMarketer. eMarketer was basically saying that audiences are 85% more likely to trust their host. And they're 85% more likely, if they trust them, to then purchase what they're advertising on their podcast. It's trust through association. Imagine that. Somebody hearing an ad on your platform or hearing you read an ad for your own business, right? For your own services. And they say, oh, wow, John has been talking about this particular camera for a while. John says he uses this camera. John gives me good information every week. John gives me value every week on his podcast. Man, it's time for me to get a new camera. And John keeps talking about this camera and they sponsor the show. I can help John out if I buy a camera. Let me go ahead and buy the camera because John said it's going to work. But here's the best part, right? Because, you know, there's that piece where, you know, you can collect a little bit on the back end. But then when they get the camera and then they enjoy it and they're like, wow, John really didn't lead me astray. He gave me great information here. John, thanks. This was awesome, dude. Then what's going to happen next? They're going to buy again. And they're going to trust me even more. Because now I'm helping them upgrade their quality of video. Because before they needed a camera, they just may have not known which camera to get. But I help provide and add value and clarity there. And the final point I want to just share is we're in a time right now to where artists have been tired of getting taken advantage of, signing bad deals and bad contracts, and creators are wanting to have their own freedom. Companies even want the ability to advertise freely as well. We're in a place where people are fed up and they want more in terms of ownership. They want more to be able to say about their own brand and not have anybody tell them what they can and what they can't say, what they can and what they can't do. So I want you to think about this. And this is going to be a bummer right here. I'm telling you, this is about to be, I'm about to throw a curveball. Okay, so look, that was the baseball noise. If anybody's familiar, but look, imagine this, right? Imagine that one day Facebook shut down. You couldn't get back on. Instagram shut down. You can't post anything. Twitter shut down. TikTok shut down. Snapchat shut down. Whatever social media platform that you use to advertise your business. Imagine if all of those shut down one day. How would you promote your business? Because you're steadily now promoting on other people's platform. You're promoting on leased space. You're leasing space on Instagram. You're leasing space on TikTok, on Twitter, on YouTube, on Snapchat. The seventh point I got for you today, when you have your own podcast, you have complete and total control and ownership of what goes out, when it goes out, how much you're putting out. Complete and total control. You have the opportunity to position your message, your product, and your service however you see fit. We've seen the social platforms shut down. We've seen in people's profile, it says, oh, I got hacked at 63K. Now I have 6 followers. I'm starting over. What? No. When you have a podcast, you own the platform. Period. So now you have the information. The question is, what are you going to do with it? And I just want to let you know, once again, we have the training coming up from our speakers, coaches, and consultants, right? You can go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. Getpaidwithpodcasting.com. I have the link down in the show notes to where you can go in, you can register, and get signed up for the training. Because I'm going to walk you through how to start a podcast. I'm going to walk you through that in my training. And then after I do that, then I'm going to come back and then I'm going to show you exactly how you can take your voice and turn into a profitable business. This is all going down in the free training. So be sure to hit the link down in the show notes to get signed up and get in the number. And now we're going to do the recap, going to do the Cliff Notes version of the show. And this is why, ultimately, why your business needs a podcast. The first reason I just hit you with was it allows you to increase your rank in terms of SEO and search results. So when people are searching for frequently used terms and things like that, your name will start to come up towards the top, the more content you put out around that specific area, that specific niche, which I would encourage to be around your business. All right. The second thing is you become an authority in the industry by talking about something often. So first it helps your search results, but then when people continually see you for this topic, they're going to associate trust and status with you continuing to show up. Got it. Podcast tribes are loyal listeners. The third reason is you want to create a space for loyal listeners. You want to create a space for the people that have signed up for your stuff and they enjoy getting it, but they want more. You want to create a space for them to come on in here. Come get some more content. Come on in here. Let's go. Number four is it's easy to repurpose the content. When you have a podcast, it's easy to snip this, cut this, put out the audio clip, put out the video. Number five is you have the ability to build an intimate connection with a listener and potential customer like no other thing. Podcast is better than a book. A podcast is better than a business card. A podcast is in your ears and it goes into your brain, your most intimate parts, wherever you are. Number six, loyal listeners can be loyal customers. Loyal listeners can be loyal customers now. Don't sleep on that. And if somebody's a loyal customer, that means they're coming back. They're coming back. And then number seven is you have complete and total control of what goes out. You have complete and total say-so of the platform. What you put out, how much you put out, when you put it out, it's all on you, my friend. It's all on you. Thank you so much for taking the time to rock today on Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. If this added any value to you whatsoever, I would encourage you to go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com and then right at the top, you can leave a ranking or you can write a review. Either would help the show continue to grow and continue to expand the message so we can help more individuals, more speakers, coaches, and consultants get their message out to the masses to continue to impact more lives. So family, I appreciate you. I hope you're having an amazing week. And until next time, this is the Your Podcast Mentor Show, your number one source for podcast news, podcast how-tos, and interviews. But we here help you establish your platform so that you can profit on purpose from your podcast. Peace and God bless.